kids in America today are fat. I mean, they've got these little games. It's just your fingers that you're moving. You're not out and about. Lazy.
I tell you what let's do. We'll get them grandkids. I got a little piece of ground, a lot of brush and stuff in there, and have them clean that whole thing as slick as a button. You know, it's Papaw work day.
That is a fun show. It's called Duck Dynasty. It's taken America by storm. The highest rated cable show ever, actually. It's on arts and entertainment. I guess you'd call it redneck reality TV. And part of the reason it was so flavorful is because these Southern conservatives were so Christian in their life. They weren't hiding it. They were authentic. That's what made it click. But that's what also got that fella there, Phil Robertson, fired. He gave an interview with GQ magazine in which he said a number of things about the differences between being gay and being straight. Here's one of the things he said. He was asked about sinning, and he said, start with homosexual behavior and just morph out from there. Bestiality, sleeping around with this woman and that woman and that woman and those men. And he goes on listing sins, but he called homosexuality one of those sins. He described the act and said, sex with a woman is better. That's what he said. And he was sacked. Well, was that the right thing for A&E to do? Is that censorship? Or is that just a corporation taking care of its public reputation? Joining us now from Ottawa to talk about this is Matt Buffton. He's the executive director of the Institute for Liberal Studies. Hey, welcome to the show, Matt. It's been a long time.
Thanks for having me, Ezra.
Nice to see you. Now, by liberal studies, you mean liberal in a good way, as in the Latin root of that word is in freedom, right?
You got it. We're talking about Adam Smith and John Locke and all those good guys.
Now, we just talked recently in an earlier segment about the Alberta Human Rights Commission that censors people using the iron fist of the state. It's different when a private company makes an internal decision like this, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is something a gentleman I'm a big fan of, and you probably are too, Friedrich Hayek, has called this sort of a gentler form of coercion. So what is great to see, I think, is whether A&E made the right decision or wrong decision is really up to them in the end. But this case isn't going before a human rights tribunal or anything like that, right? The people who own the show are making decision about what their audience wants, and they're free to do so.
Yeah, and it may be an extremely expensive decision for them. I mean, it may cause a boycott of their show. It may cause their audience to leave. Who knows, the rest of the family, because it is a family, this Duck Dynasty refers to, they make these duck calls, the whole family, they may leave for another network. So this may be a multi-million dollar decision. If they're free to choose to fire Phil, their audience is free to fire A&E, right?
Yeah, absolutely. It works both ways. I think it'll be interesting to see how it shakes out. Personally, I suspect the show will actually do better because of this, because I don't think they're going to lose a lot of the audience. You know, I watched an episode of the show for the first time this afternoon, and, you know, I wasn't surprised to hear that he'd be making these remarks after watching the show. So I think the audience probably already knows, and they're probably just going to get more publicity from the fact that people like you and I are talking about this today.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty tough to claim that having Christian conservative views on matters of sexuality, that would be a surprise to this show. I mean, that's what has made this show what it is. I mean, that's why it's a reality show and not scripted by a bunch of liberals in Hollywood. I think the key decision is in the next few days about the contract that the family signed with them. Maybe the family has signed an exclusive deal and they can't get out. Maybe they're going to sacrifice their dad to keep the big bucks coming with A&E. It'll be interesting to see how that all shakes down. Now, in Canada, there's a chance this guy would have been hit with a human rights complaint, don't you think?
Exactly. I think that's a real danger. When people talk about censorship, the fact that A&E wants this guy off the air, they have a contract with, to me, that's not censorship. That's just using one of those lighter forms of coercion. You know, there's an example of these sorts of social norms in place. Eleanor Ostrom, the Nobel Prize-winning political scientist, used these sorts of things about how society can govern itself without having to rely on government, having to rely on coercion. And I think this is a really healthy example of how when society sort of disagrees with speech, we can express our views or disagree with the fact, the decision to cancel him, to express those views, and none of this requires governments or bureaucrats or censors.
Yeah. You know what? I mean, I think A&E here is reacting to bullies. I mean, I think that the gay rights movement used to be about liberty and free expression and tolerating people with differences, and I think there's a bit of a fascist element in some parts of the gay political movement, and they want to punish folks who have a different opinion. But that is a private decision by A&E. If this was the FCC, that's the regulator of TV shows, of Federal Communications Commission down there, then it would be an outrage because that would violate the First Amendment freedoms of Phil Robinson and the show. Last word to you, Matt. Do you think, how do you think this will wind up? Do you think the show will continue? Sounds like you think it's actually just a PR buzz for them.
Well, I think it's probably going to help them, but I think you're absolutely right. And this should show the FCC they don't need to police what's said on the airwaves because the audience and the corporations will do it for them.
Yeah, right on. Thanks for joining us today. It's an interesting discussion.